This is Shahida Hill, getting you over the hill to home ownership and helping you confidently buy your first home. Today, we're talking all about the lending process for you as a buyer. When should you apply? When should you do your mortgage application? What you should ask the lender, how to get the best interest rates. I'm gonna give you a lot of information in this video, so please take good notes. Please like and subscribe to my channel for new videos every week. Please like this video. It helps the algorithm. It helps it reach more people. So let's get started with when. I think that you should start your mortgage application 3 to 4 months before you want to actively start looking for a home. If you know you've researched everything else, you've done my checklist, you know you have good credit, you know that you have good income, everything's pretty stable. If you're unsure and you're maybe 6 months out or a year out, then I think you should do an application just to see where you stand. So a lender can give you some guidance. You might be fine, you might be ready to go, and then you won't do your application again until 3 to 4 months out. But if you're really unsure, you wanna be, you know, be really prepared because you're definitely buying a home in a year, or you're definitely buying a home in 6 months, go ahead and do the application early just to see where you stand, see if there's anything you need to work on, and then you know, you'll have at least a game plan. But generally speaking, do it 3 to 4 months out before you want to actually be in your home. All right, so that's when you should do it. Now, where should you find a lender? Now, my advice is to find the realtor first, and then have them advise you on what lenders you should use. And my reason for that is because if you have an experienced realtor, they know the best lenders for your situation. So they can't really advise you, okay, well, you need down payment assistance. No, you have really good credit. They have great interest rates with this lender. They can help you navigate that a little bit more as a first-time home buyer. However, if you do want to do your own research, I would definitely, if you don't use your lender's recommendation, where you currently bank, your current bank or credit union, your online banks, or by referrals, or some other people that have bought homes in the past and have had a good experience with their lender. So, you know, online options, you can use references from other people that have closed before, and then your current bank or credit union. My only thing I want to mention with your current bank or credit union, that, you know, say Bank of America or large banks, Navy Federal, you know, those kinds of places, generally speaking, they take a little bit longer to close. So you wanna check all of those things ahead of time. I'm gonna give you some questions you need to ask your lender that will be helpful for you to know up front. And then the other one is for online banks. Really think about a lot of real estate agents. Say you get an older real estate agent that doesn't really trust online approvals, then you might be at a disadvantage. So if you're gonna go with an online bank like Quicken or Rocket Mortgage or something like that, then I want you to also do a more traditional lender as well. So at least you have two pre-approvals and you could, you know, use one or the other. In a seller's market, they're really looking at everything to be, you know, it's very competitive. So part of that getting accepted is who you are getting your financing from. And if that lender doesn't trust an online only bank just because maybe they don't have experience with them, then that might be an issue, and you don't want that to stop you from getting your offer accepted. So a lot of times it's good for you to have at least one pre-approval from a local lender that, you know, is known in the area, so people are familiar with them. All right, so now you know when, and now you know how you're gonna find your lender. Now, how are you gonna get the best interest rates? You're gonna get it two ways. One is you are going to quote with at least three different lenders. So you are going to quote with at least three different lenders. You don't have to do this if you're just kind of seeing where you are, but if you're in that 3 months out and you're ready to move within 3 to 4 months, then you do want to start those quotes then to see, okay, where do I stand? Which lender is going to give me the best rate, and who am I ultimately going to go with? And you'll be able to, just by doing those three quotes, you'll be able to see if you're getting the best rates. There's also an online site that the government has that will tell you, they keep track of lenders or in order to know if they're doing fair lending practices and all that, they keep track of what lenders, what kind of interest rates lenders are giving people. So there's an online site, I'm gonna link it in the description. You could put in your state, your credit score, and they will tell you what people on average are getting for that loan type in your state, what interest rate they are getting. So that's a good starting point to see, okay, if most people are getting say a 2.75 and I'm being quoted a 3.5, then that's an issue. That's not the best rate for me. There's some other people getting better rates. And again, it goes by credit score and it goes by down payment and loan types. So all of those things do factor in, but by getting at least three quotes, by using that site to see where the majority of people are falling in your state, that's a good guideline to know if you're getting the best interest rate. Now, once you do your application, so you pick your lender, you do your application, they are required to give you a loan estimate within 3 days of that application. So they're going to give you a loan estimate that will include the interest rate, their fees, closing costs, all of that. I'm also going to link below to a sample loan estimate because that's how you're going to compare which one is giving you the best rate. And it may not be that you're getting just the lowest interest rate. You also need to look at all the fees with that loan. So you have an interest rate, then you have an APR, like an annual annual percentage rate. And that rate will show you everything with the fees or the total cost of the loan. So when you're comparing what loan is the best one for you, you want to look at the total cost of the loan. And they are required, after you do the full application, to give you an estimate within 3 days of that application. So get your estimate. Now, if you do your application and you're denied, if you are denied the mortgage, they're not going to give it to you for whatever reason. It's usually going to be income, credit, or debt. That's the reason why you were denied. They have to tell you in writing why you were denied. Okay. And they'll probably tell you verbally as well. It's a good opportunity for you to have a conversation with the lender. If you are denied, to say, what can I do to improve? Where does my income need to be? Where does my credit need to be? What do I need to pay off? What do I need to do in order to get qualified for a mortgage? And they also, by law, have to give it to you in writing if you've requested it. And I'm going to put that link below so you know what you're talking about when you're speaking with the lender if you are denied. But at least in denial, you have a plan. You know what to do next. So it's not always a bad thing necessarily. At least you know you did your application. Now you know what you need to do in order to get approved. All right, so now let's talk about what you need to do as far as asking them questions. Like what some questions you need to ask the lender. After you get all your information, you get your estimates, what do you need to ask them? I think the number one question to ask them is communication. Because a lot of first-time homebuyers specifically say, well, how often should the lender call me? I haven't heard any updates about my loan. You want to ask them how often they communicate with their clients. So once you choose a lender and you're under contract, so you know that's when you need them, when you have a contract. You're under contract on a home, you're trying to go through the process, you need to reach them, or there's paperwork you need to submit. How often will they communicate with you? If you have trouble reaching them during the application process, like you can't, you know, they're not answering your emails or your phone calls during the application, think about that during the actual process of your mortgage. Will they be the same? And typically they are. So if they're not very responsive when you're doing your application, they may not be very responsive when you're under contract. So just, you know, however somebody's showing, what did Maya Angelou say? When somebody shows you who they are, believe them. If they're not responsive to you during the application phase, they're probably not going to be responsive to you during the actual, when you're under contract. So that's number one. Find out how they communicate and how often they communicate. Maybe they have an assistant that's going to communicate with you. Find all of that out ahead of time. Number two, also very important, can you take me through underwriting ahead of time. Most lenders take you through underwriting, and if you haven't watched my underwriting video, watch that. Most lenders take you through underwriting after you are under contract. When somebody has accepted your offer and you're under contract, they take your loan from pre-approved to approved. That process can be done ahead of time. Like, they can go ahead and look at your documents more carefully ahead of time. And the advantage for you is that you can close faster. A lot of buyers, especially in this market, in the seller's market, are losing out to other buyers because they can't close as quickly. So say typically you close in 30 days. If you're through underwriting, you might be able to close in 10 days or 14 days. So ask them if they can take you through underwriting ahead of time. Is that an option? And if not, ask them how quickly you can come through underwriting, because most loans are going to have a finance contingency, basically saying, if I can't get my loan approved within 21 days or whatever you negotiate, if I can't get my loan approved by that time, I basically can't terminate my contract and get the earnest money back. And that's a risk to the seller to say, you know, I'm gonna put my home under contract, but there's a chance that this person's financing won't go through. So they usually want really short finance contingencies. So to have like a really competitive offer, you want a short finance contingency. So you want to ask the lender, how quickly can you get me through underwriting to get from pre-approved to approved? Also ask them the same thing for the appraisal. How quickly, once I'm under contract, can I get my home appraised? Because again, you probably will have an appraisal contingency. And in that appraisal contingency, again, that seller is looking at, let me try to reduce my risk with very short time frames. But if you need a long time, then it's going to be an issue. I had a bank, I'm not gonna name the name, but they required a 60-day closing. Like, they needed 60 days for everything, and that was so difficult for my client to navigate in multiple offer situations that we had to switch lenders to make her more competitive. So you want to know up front, what is are their closing time frames. Also ask them, are you willing to call the seller on my behalf? A lot of people are missing out on homes because, say you do have a good offer in, that selling agent, or sorry, that listing agent is going to call, if they're a good agent, they are going to call to verify your financing. They are going to call to verify, I just want to make sure I have a really good offer in front of me. I have the pre-approval. Please let me know how's their credit. Tell me basically if this is legitimate, that you've looked at all their documents, they've been through at least manual or automated underwriting, that this, you know, is a really good loan. And there's like a list of questions that listing agents may ask. They can't give you all your personal information, but they can tell, you know, the realtor, you know, basic things, you know, like, this is basically a really good risk for you. Like, this person has very strong financials. They can share that with them. But if they're not willing to talk or call the seller on your behalf, then, not everybody is willing to do that, but that's an extra advantage for you if they are willing. And I've had some of my lenders call, like, I send the offer over and the lender calls. I just wanted to verify. I know they put an offer on this house. They're really excited about it. They have really strong financials. They're good to go. So you want to, have somebody that's going to have your back, as you know, especially in a seller's market. Now, I'm not really numbering these, but this is number four. How soon can I lock in my rate? How soon can I lock in my rate? The rate they quote you during the application period. So the rate they quote you during the application can change. It's floating, okay, until you're under contract. They typically cannot lock your rate until you're under contract. So you want to know how quickly can you lock, or how long can you lock my rate? So if it's floating, can I lock it for 30 days? Can I lock it for 60 days? How quickly can I lock it so I can get that interest rate in? And they should be able to advise you if you should lock it. Now, like, this year, interest rates have been all over the place. For the most part, they've been low, but like right at the pandemic, they went high, they went low again. So you want to know, how does the rate lock process work? And every lender is different. How soon can I lock in my rate? What's the process of locking my rate? How do I inform you that I want to lock my rate? I want you to talk that through with them. And then, so say you do lock it. You lock it at 3%. And then something happens with the market or something like that, and the rate drops. Now the rates are 2.5%. What is your option to break your lock and to lock at the lower rate? Is that an option for you? Generally, there's going to be a fee, but you want to know what that fee is upfront, or if it's possible for you to unlock your rate after you locked it, okay? So ask them those questions. Now you know how to find your lender, what to ask them before and after your application, and you also have all of the links below that will help you find the best interest rate and know exactly what a loan estimate should look like. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my channel for new videos every week.